Okay students, now going to discuss about the mechanism of breathing. Mechanism of breathing. What do you know about the breathing? Breathing is the exchange of gases between the lungs and the outer atmospheric air other than the energy producing sides. It's called breathing. Okay, and it is the mechanism of breathing involves two steps. One is the inspiration and the one is the expiration. Okay, and in this, lungs are the main respiratory organs in the human beings. These are present in the thoracic chamber. Okay, one pair lungs which are also situated, it is also called airtight chamber. It is formed by dorsally vertebral foramen and ventrally by sternum, laterally ribs, and lower it consists of dome shaped diaphragm. Students, our diaphragm is with the muscle called phrenic muscle, phrenic muscles, and between the ribs, okay, 12 pair ribs present in the human beings. These are the ribs are jointed. Okay, between the ribs there is a muscles are called external intercostal muscles and the internal intercostal muscles. Okay, these muscles also helps in mechanism of the breathing. Okay, mainly two types of the muscles helps in mechanism of the breathing. Which are the muscles? These are external intercostal muscles present between the ribs, and another one is phrenic muscle which is present in the dome shaped diaphragm. Okay students, this is the diagrammatic part that shows the mechanism of the breathing. This is the about the inspiration, this is about the expiration. Okay, and this first one, in the mechanism of the breathing, first one is inspiration. What about the inspiration? Intake of air into the lungs, intake of air from the atmospheric air into the lungs through the respiratory tract is called inspiration. It is the active process. And in this, two muscles already you know, first one is the phrenic muscle, second one is external intercostal muscles, goes to the contraction. In this, first one, phrenic muscle goes to the contraction. Dome shaped diaphragm is changes into flattened. It causes the increasing of the thoracic volume anterior and posteriorly. Okay students, next another one of the muscle, that is external intercostal muscles goes to the contraction. It causes the increasing of the thoracic cavity dorso ventrally. It leads to the ribs and the sternum comes into up position. Okay, lift up and also raised. Okay, ribs and the sternum are raises. Okay, or lift up, and it causes the increasing of the thoracic volume, thoracic cavity dorso ventrally. The students, and overall increase of the thoracic cavity, thoracic volume increases the pulmonary volume. Volume of the lungs is increases, and it causes decreasing of the intrapulmonary pressure is decreases. And at the same time, intrapulmonary pressure decreases than the outer atmospheric air. So the air present in the outer atmospheric air is entered into the lungs through the respiratory tract. It is called inspiration. It is the intrapulmonary pressure is decreased than the atmospheric pressure. So the air present in the atmospheric air is entered into the lungs through the respiratory tract. Okay, students. Next, another one is the expiration. Expiration, it is the diagram that shows the part of the inspiration. Air comes into the lungs. Volume of the thoracic cavity is increases. Okay, students. Another, these are the linear arrangement of the vertebrae. Okay. And expiration. What about the expiration? Expiration means release of the alveolar air. Alveoli present in the lungs. These are alveoli filled with the carbon dioxide with air. Okay. That is the air present in the alveoli is called alveolar air. Alveoli filled with the air, that one is goes to the exterior, expelled to the outside. That is called expiration. It is the passive process. Expiration is the passive process. Okay, students. And in this first one, relaxation goes to the relaxation. Two types of the muscles goes to the relaxation. In this first one, relaxation of the phrenic muscles. Phrenic muscles present in the diaphragm. Relaxation of the phrenic muscles, it causes the decreasing of the thoracic cavity. Decreasing of thoracic cavity anterior posteriorly. And it comes into original position, dome shaped structure. Diaphragm comes into dome shaped position. And another, relaxation of the external intercostal muscles. Okay, this is the dome shape. This is the dome shaped diaphragm. And relaxation of the external intercostal muscles present between the ribs. And ribs are comes to its original position. Original position, ribs and the sternum comes into its original position. What do you know about the sternum? Sternum is the middle bone. It is firstly forms in amphibians, in the vertebrates. Okay. All the ribs are attached to the sternum, middle part of the bone. Okay. By the relaxation of the external intercostal muscles present between the ribs, at the same time, ribs and the sternum comes into its original position. This causes the decreasing of the thoracic cavity. Overall decreasing of the thoracic cavity decreases the pulmonary volume. And it causes, when the pulmonary volume is decreases, it increases the intrapulmonary pressure. Increasing the intrapulmonary pressure. Pressure within the lungs is called intrapulmonary pressure. By this is the intrapulmonary pressure is increases than the outer pressure of the outer atmosphere. Okay, the air present in the alveoli expelled to the outside through the respiratory tract. This is called expiration. Okay, students. Now, what about the forced expiration? Forced expiration means it is occurs due to the forced expiration. Expel the air from the lungs to outside by forced expiration. It is caused by the contraction of the internal intercostal muscles present between the ribs and lateral abdominal muscles.
lateral abdominal muscles. Both of the muscles goes to the contraction. It is causes the forced expiration. It leads to forced expiration. Okay, students. These are the arrow marks that shows the entry of the air into the thoracic cavity or lungs. And these are the arrow marks in the expiration that shows the expel of the air present in the lungs to outside. Okay, another healthy adult human beings breathe approximately 12 to 16 times per minute. 12 to 16 times per minute. Okay, students. Next, another, the volume of the air at the time of the breathing can be estimated, determined by the spirometer, by the help of the spirometer.